If you are a budding entrepreneur, okay, and you are struggling to get clients, okay, or you may have 10 or more than 10, 15 years of experience, and you have people leaving your team, people leaving your company, you know, right? In the current situation, there are a lot of iteration happening in all the companies, right? Any of these situations, if you fall, my today's talk will definitely help you, right? So, hi guys, this is Karthik here. By profession, I'm into software, and by passion, I'm a hash relationship growth coach, right? So I was talking about this book in my last talk, if you remember, right? I was talking about connecting, how communicating effectively connecting is more important, how it influences others, right? So today we'll continue with this, and I have multiple stories to share till the end. I hope it adds value to you. Okay, to start with, I will want to share this story. In 2019, right, when I lost my mom during the day of funeral, I mean, it was unexpected, and we were so emotionally disturbed since it was unexpected. And on the day of funeral, how the activities will be. I don't have any such experience before, and it was so tiring. And after that, in our rituals, we have some 13-14 days rituals to do, okay, following to that day. So we had this Purohit who was doing all this, and he said he will come home in the evening and he will explain what are the rituals to be done, all that stuff. Okay. So since I didn't have much idea on this, I thought, okay, he will come for 10-15 minutes, maybe he'll explain and he'll leave. And he came and he started talking. So what needs to be done, what I have to do, what the family has to do, and what we have to get things to be, so many things. It played 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hour. He was talking. I was like, I was sleeping in between. He was still talking. Can you believe it? I'm just in front of him. Okay. At home. Okay. Is he a person? Is he able to understand me? Right. So what I was wanted to share is, right, some people, they are so self-centered, they will not understand others, right? So, and this guy lacked that connect. And that day I got a bad impression on this guy. Next 13, 14 days, I had to bear him and I had to pay him and it's over. Otherwise we didn't call him again. Okay, there was no connect. He was not able to understand what is my situation. Okay, he was just want to dump all his information to me. That's all, okay? So today I want to cover about an important aspect. Communication is all about others, right? So I want to quickly share my screen. I hope you are able to see this, right? So you know this picture, right? From this guy. So there is no I in team, but there is an M and an E, and that spells me, right? So I was able to relate to what he, the situation he was in, because I was like this few years back. And when I was working with a team of individuals, I was more concentrating on my desires, my goals, and my ambitions, right? And needless to say, they didn't last with long, okay? We are friends, but we don't work with each other, right? Because I was so self-centered, okay? I think many of you, us will be able to relate. So why do so many people miss this, okay? It's not about me. Why do so many people miss this? Let us quickly see that, okay? One is immaturity. Okay, so as I told, maturity does not always come with age. Okay, we need to understand what other persons is. Okay, so many of us will, given a chance, we'll showcase all our brilliance and expertise by giving all the information, right? Second thing is ego. Third thing is failure to value everyone. Okay, so to add value to others, one must first value others, right? So, because, right, see, if you are doing everything alone, you can't accomplish much, okay? You need people to work with you. You need to work through people, right? So, author gives this example. In this one executive meeting, this American meets a Japanese, right? And the American asked this Japanese, right? In world trade, what is the most important language, okay? So, the American thought he would tell English. But the Japanese was a very, he had so much understanding of business, and he told, the most important language is our customer's language, right? Mm-hmm. So what is the next thing? Insecurity, right? So these are some 4 points which, people may miss to know about others, right? So we'll quickly move over 3 questions people want to know, right? So first thing is, do you care for me, right? So good relations usually lead to good things, ideas, growth, partnerships, and more. Okay, there should be a mutual concern so that there will be a connection between two people, right? So can you help me? Okay, nobody wants to be sold, but everyone wants to be helped, right? So I remember this thing which happened, I mean, last month, when I called my customer care of a network provider, right? So I wanted to change this, my plan. So I was very busy. My agenda was, I'll give my requirement. She will tell me what is the plan suiting my requirement. And I'll ask her to change my plan. I'll close the call. This was as simple as that. But when I called her, I just told one sentence and she started explaining all the plans, all the benefits, all the features of the plans, everything. I was like, she's not connecting with me again, right? So we need to see, there is a bit difference between feature and a benefit. If you have a product or a service, right? And if you are trying to explain all the features and all the, the product has to a customer, right? He may not be so interested, right? What he or she more interested in, how can that product solve his or her problem? Okay, what is the benefit? Right, there's a big difference between feature and a benefit, right? And the third thing is, can I trust you? Okay, so business goes where it wants, but it stays where it's appreciated, right? So a lot of times, you know, so trust overtakes love, okay? So before I end with another story, I want to summarize this. If you want to connect with others, you need to add value to others. If you want to add value, you need to, if you don't know, ask questions, right? Know what the other person values of, right? And second thing is, in a group, if you are communicating, see what the strengths are for individual people, right? And work on their strengths, right? So to end this, I will share one nice story. And this story has so much of meaning, right? There was this very famous coffee company in US, right? And there comes two people to visit this coffee shop in US. And they like this very much. And they thought, okay, we'll take the rights and start it in Australia, where they belong to. Okay. So they take the rights and start a store in Sydney. But they were struggling because the business was not happening. It was very good. It was very good in US, but not in Australia. After so much of research, feedback, and they understood that people were not able to connect. Why? Because they had the model of US, right? People were asking, where are the tables? Where is the food? It was like a takeaway concept that was working in US, but it doesn't work in Sydney. So these founders understood this and they took 2 years to remodel everything and people started pouring in. Okay. After 10, 15 years, this famous coffee company, right? They had some 300 or 400 branches in 15 countries, right? So these founders says one important line, which I would like to end this with. Okay. We are not in a coffee business serving people. We are in serving we are in the business of serving people with coffee. I'll repeat it. We are not in the business of serving coffee with two people. We are in the business of serving people with coffee, right? So I hope it adds a lot of value. Thank you so much.